Hello, good morning. Oh, so many people. A bit nervous. Do you guys all know each other? Is it just one big family or group? So, feels like I'm Justin Bieber here with the audience. This is my name, Jordy from the Nieuwendijk. Hope you can read it all the way in the back. It's quite a hard name to remember. You might want to write it down or make a picture of it. Yeah, I live in The Hague. That's a city between Amsterdam and Rotterdam. It's near the beach. It's basically like Barcelona, but without all the fun stuff. And that's where my old house looked like this. And yeah, that's where I draw. It's where I paint. It's where I'm a drawing teacher at the Royal Academy. And it's good times. All right, so drawing. I went to primary school, I think most of us did, and at primary school I was I was like thin and with white hair, always drawing inside. I wasn't that good at sports. I was really bad at sports actually. I was unable for some reason to catch a ball. So I always got the balls in my face, and I think the amount of face balls even made the shape of my face. If I was good at sports, I would have a total different head. Would like totally look different. So I was good at drawing, well at least it maybe that's a weird thing to say about yourself. But I remember that if I did drawings on the big school board, I got the attention from the class. If I did fun drawings of the teacher, everyone was laughing. If I made cartoons, everyone was reading them. So I figured, hey, maybe I can do something in drawing. This drawing thing is something I am good at. And when you get a drawing in your face, it's like not even hurting. So it was a safe place for me to do. And even more important, maybe, I figured out the moment I did Tweety, like the yellow little thingy. If I drew Tweety, all the girls from my classroom were like all standing next to my desk and throwing their underwear at me in age six. I know, they all thought I was cute with the drawing thing. And then high school. After primary school, we go to high school. I think it's the same in Britain. And it's where you figure out that you're not the center of the universe and that you have to, you know, look at yourself and see who you are and what you're doing. And I kind of didn't want to be cute anymore. I think all the guys that had scooters and were smoking and were like all cool at high school got attention, and I was like drawing Tweety still, aged 12. Like, look at this, I made a drawing, no one's interested. So I thought of like, what's the coolest thing you can do with drawing? Like, what's a cool thing you can do with drawing? And I ended up doing graffiti for a couple of years. And yeah, that was a fun period, lots of adventures. It was basically extreme drawing, maybe, even. It's like drawing and running from the police. It's like this really cool mix. And working at night, which I think I started working at night doing graffiti even. Wow, never figured that one out. So yeah, I did a lot of graffiti with some friends. This is me standing next to my graffiti. I was also a graffiti model, as you can see. And I had this horrible thing where I have like hair in my neck. Sorry, I was told not to turn away from the microphone because, you know. Graffiti, I don't even think, this is recorded, right? I don't think my parents know, so. Mom, Dad, if you're hearing this, I'm sorry. We talk about it when I'm home, all right? It's just I had to do this thing. It's creativity, I should get it out of my. So graffiti was fun and cool. And I learned doing a lot of paintings and drawings in the same style, in the same color palette, because as you don't really put your name under it, you can't really put your real name under graffiti because you'll ring your bell and, collect money. As you are damaging other people's property. Like other people, I'm sorry. We can talk about it when I'm home. We'll be right. So as you can see, my favorite colors were black and white and gray. And like every time people saw the work, they like, oh, that's that guy again. So I learned, because basically I want to show my work to as many people as possible. I want to show my work. I want to make sure a lot of people see your work. I learned doing that by doing graffiti. And then I went to high school and I figured out that I needed the attention that I needed, that I had at primary school. I kind of missed it doing graffiti. Like all my friends said I was cool, and you know, because they're my friends. And strangers never knew who I was and who the guy was behind the work, and I missed that. So when I went to, it's not that smart to show footage like this, right, on the internet. This is from Getty Images, it's not my. So I started studying illustration in Rotterdam, and I did a graffiti thing where I worked a lot in the same color palette to be recognizable. And this time I spread my work in magazines, on t-shirts, on stickers, and tried to find a more legal way to make sure a lot of people see my work, and I was really pushing that. I was doing a lot of these drawings, also robots and characters, I don't know, from outer space, and had aliens, and I was doing this whole day, every day. Yeah, and I figured, like, Jordy van den Nieuwendijk, remember that name? Wasn't really a good name. Yeah, it was maybe too Dutch for all these figures I did all the time, so I made up an artist name. I came with the name Super Robot Turbo. Also a thing from graffiti, where you make up another name and you work from that name. So I called myself Super Robot Turbo and did a lot of drawings. And yeah, I did that for 4 years, and I got bored with it, I think. Also because I was starting graphic design studying at the Royal Academy in The Hague. And at some point I just tried to spice it up a little bit more, so I took the little cute drawings and figures and I added like sticks of flesh and balloon thingies on them, just to try to kill the sweet and the cute thing I was doing all the time. And I think that's the period where I started to realize that I was Super Robot Turbo at home, and I got assignments, I got clients, I was earning a little bit of money with it. And at art school, I was Jordy van den Nieuwendijk, and it was just, I didn't know who I was and what I was doing. I was like, who am I, a graphic designer or an illustrator, or am I Super Robot Turbo, or do I want to change that? And I was really struggling with it. And here you can see it, two big paintings I did, where it's Super Robot Turbo with my head and my body with Super Robot Turbo's head. I did all kinds of things. Like I just did them for fun back then, but now when I look at them, I was like, oh, maybe of course I was struggling with that. Like unhappy people and like even the assignments on art school, I tried to figure out who I was, who is Jordy van den Nieuwendijk, who is my alter ego. And I tried to maybe get rid of it or figure out that maybe I got angry with my alter ego. I got jealous of his success because he was doing well and I was doing so shitty at art school. Like I was never at art school. I was never always late. I was just doing all my homework the day before the deadlines and having fights with teachers. And yeah, I was really angry with it. And then the last year of art school, you're supposed to do a final project. And I did a presentation where I talked about who I am and who Super Robot Turbo is, and that it's me, and that I want to get rid of it to be able to really develop myself as just one guy instead of everything divided over two. Are you taking notes? Is this like easy to follow? In the end it turned out killing my alter ego. I made a grave for Super Robot Turbo, and I just presented that at the last day of the art school. I built a thing like a little bit secretly, and I just put it there, like it's dead now. So all the teachers were quite happy with it, as they were not really a big fan of my alter ego, because it was, I think they saw potential in me and I was not living up to their expectation at art school. I was just doing the same drawings all over again all the time. So I dug a hole in the backyard of the Royal Academy and organized a funeral and a memorial service. Those are my friends, and it was raining and Ave Maria was playing and everyone was sad, and it was a good ending of the Super Robot Turbo period. And afterwards, like he's holding like a three-headed phallus. Is it too early to say phallus? It's 10. And then when it was under the ground, the only thing sticking out was like a yeah, that worked really well. And I think it was stolen the same night, but I couldn't even care. I was just done. I was free. I was myself again. I was Jordy van den Nieuwendijk. And so next on Oprah, we have a guest that's it's a bit self-analytical all the time. So Jordy van den Nieuwendijk, I was done with art school. It was like the first assignment I got was, I think, from a friend of my father. He had an outdoor shop. And I think it was not a big assignment or something special. It's just like, hey, can you maybe make business cards for me? And I'll pay you if you do that, and we are friends. And I ended up doing just a little figure. And I remember that he asked me to do line drawings only, because he wanted to print it on t-shirts or something. And I wanted to make it really colorful, so I ended up doing drawings where it was lines only, but I colored the lines. It's such a simple thing if you think about it now. But for some reason, this was really important for my illustration style, maybe. I ended up doing them like this. And this was, I put it out on the internet, and then I was asked quite a few times to work in that style, to work in the color line style. And I experimented with a little bit too much maybe in 1 year, but it was becoming quite recognizable. So maybe again as the graffiti, where I did the same thing all over again, and with the Super Robot Turbo alter ego thing, I did the same thing. And now with the colored line drawings, I did the same thing again. So I think maybe you need a certain comfort zone to work in. But I think this time I tried to do more different things with it. For some reason, they were never good enough, which I think is a good thing. When something is not good enough, imagine if cars are good enough, there will never be new cars. Or if fashion is good enough, I think if something is never good enough, you try to push it and change it. So I did this for a while, it was fun. I think I liked working for different clients, and I worked closely together with an agent in Paris, Monsieur L'Argent. I'm really unable to pronounce it. I practiced all morning. It's a hard name. And I think I enjoyed the moment I was working, like different from graffiti and Super Robot Turbo stuff. This time, it was my work, it was my drawings, but I worked together with a client, and I worked together with an art director, and they pushed me. They said, maybe you can change it, maybe you have to do it like this. And then I was like, no, I don't think so. And then I changed it, and then it looked pretty good afterwards. So I learned to work together, and I think that was really important for me to listen and to look at your work and change it and experiment. So yeah, that's what I did for a long time. I think for 4 years now already. Wow. I don't even know how old I am anymore. So then, besides all the commercial work, the commercial illustrations, I still had the need to work for myself, do drawings that are only for me, no deadlines, no art directors, no one can say anything about it, just my own personal thingies. And I really enjoy that at the moment, how I do sketches when I'm on holiday or when I'm traveling. And like a simple sketch of a plant or a few sketches of plants. I enjoy how that grows, how I do more, how I experiment with it, how I make them into different materials, like crayons or like paint even. And then the way I work is, for my personal work, the way it works, I like doing sketches and I like to do a lot. Then I take distance from it and I choose a few different ones, a few different versions. And then, I try to make it really good. Well, in a way, in a good way, I think what I'm scared of is what I messed up with the alter ego thing, is that I'm scared of really being known for one particular style, that people say, oh, that's the guy that does all the same thingy all the time, like this one trick pony. And that's, I think I want my drawings to be as Sir David Attenborough's voice. Like, he doesn't do the same thing. Like, he can read the phone book or he can do a documentary, and it always sounds good, it always has quality. I think I search for this quality in my work, that no matter what I do, it's thought of, or it's just there's put enough time in it to make it work. And so this, I like how this goes from sketches to more drawings to experiments, and then when I find a gallery that's interested in my work, I make them into paintings, see if that works, and then this is really what I enjoy doing at the moment, besides teaching at the Art Academy, but I don't really think there's time to talk about that. Are we on 13? I've got 2 more minutes left. So I'm teaching at Art Academy since a year now, which is really important to me. As I told before, I'm really messed up at the art school. I think even in the last month of my 4 years at graphic design at the Royal Academy, I discovered I had a library with all like amazing books, and I could have done so much more at art school. And being back there now as a teacher, I teach drawing class to the first year graphic design students, is really inspiring to me. And I wish I put more work in it. Time always up, almost up. I want to show you a movie I did 2 years ago. It's one of my favorite projects. I think there was a scarf company from Amsterdam, and they asked me to do a scarf. And then they sent me an interview, like, can you maybe make a movie with this interview? And they kind of asked me like why I used the color red, and like questions that weren't really interesting to me. But they asked me one question, like, why are you drawing on a scarf? And I played with that idea, like, why am I drawing on a scarf? I can basically draw on everything. And we put that in the animation. And that's playing now. still weird to see my mom on a big screen. It's not my mom. It's my dad after the operation. So basically, maybe to sum up, if you want to have an alter ego, if you want to draw, do whatever you want to do, because, I don't know, I think we can do that. As in a safe Western world where you can be anything you want and do anything you want and have a million chances every day, just, I don't know, try to find something you're good at and push it and go for it. And I think this is enough, right? Can I go?